Hi, welcome to my channel, 10 Years Younger. Now, you may have the best anti-aging skincare routine, the best sunscreen, but if you don't understand glycation, then you don't have the full anti-aging picture. So today, we're gonna look at glycation, and by the end of this video, you'll understand what it is, how it affects your skin, and most importantly, how you can avoid it. Glycation is a natural process in which sugar bonds to fat or protein. In doing this, it creates a harmful molecule called AGE, or advanced glycation end product. So age, pretty ironic. So these AGEs damage collagen and make it more brittle. Now, obviously we've got collagen in our skin, but collagen is all over our bodies. So our arteries and our blood vessels have collagen. So when they're damaged, it leads to cardiovascular disease and age-related diseases and strokes and diabetes, all kind of complications. But what we're looking at today is specifically the effect on the skin. So the skin cells, after the AGEs have attacked them, they become brittle, which means our skin sags and it wrinkles. So it accelerates the aging process of our skin. So there are two ways that AGEs can build up in our body. So the first is by eating or drinking too much sugar. So simple sugar such as glucose, fructose, and galactose. Galactose sounds like it should come from another universe. I love that, galactose. Yeah, so fructose, you would think it's healthy sugar because it comes from fruit, but actually it has 10 times as much glycation activity as glucose does. The second way is that when you cook food, or specifically food which is high in protein or fat, like meat, eggs, butter, mayonnaise, things like that, when you cook that with dry heat, and by dry heat I mean barbecue, roasting, toasting, frying or baking, you increase the AGEs by over 100% in that food. So the AGEs are in the food before we eat it. So the opposite to that is wet cooking. So that would be boiling, steaming, poaching, or stewing, and that does not create any AGEs. Your body has a natural process of eliminating harmful AGE compounds, but if you consume too many, they will build up faster than your body can eliminate them. So how do you know if you're eating too much AGE in your diet? Well, AGEs are measured in kilo units, and it's recommended that you shouldn't have more than 15,000 a day. Now, I'm going to show you a chart on the screen now, which has some everyday foods to give you an idea of how much you're eating every day. So what's the solution? Well, over the last 7 months, I've been looking into various solutions that can address the glycation issue. Firstly, there's an amino acid supplement called carnosine, which can reverse the glycation process and return proteins to their normal shape and function. Now, I was looking for a long time to find this online, and I only found one retailer that sells this. And the thing is, when you Google carnosine, Google confuses carnosine with carnitine, and carnitine is a weight training supplement. It's something completely different. So don't get confused, you want carnosine. And I only found one retailer, like I said. They're in New York and they're called Piping Rock, and I'm going to link this below. This was £8, that was without the shipping, and this is mixed with zinc. Now, zinc is also a great supplement to take, but what you need to be aware of is I also take a daily multivitamin and mineral supplement, which contains 145% of my daily zinc already. This has 145% of my daily zinc intake as well. So the important thing is that you're not taking more than 50 milligrams of zinc a day. That otherwise you can start to get ill through too much zinc. So this is a carnosine, the only one from what I can see that's available. So I've been taking this for couple of months. I think this is something that takes, you know, a few months to kick in. Number two is antioxidants, but specifically green tea has been shown to interfere with the glycation process. So I found this green tea supplement. I mean, you can just drink green tea if you like drinking tea. I'm not really a fan of tea, so it's easy for me to take these every day. I got this from Holland & Barrett, which is a store in the UK, and I paid about £6 for these. Number three, obviously reducing the amount of sugar that you're eating. So in the UK, it's recommended that you have a maximum of 30 grams of sugar every day. Now, I thought I was a healthy eater, But when I added up my daily sugar intake, I found I was having just under 90 grams of sugar a day, and that shocked me. But mostly it came from hidden sources like breakfast cereal, salad dressings, yogurt, things that I thought were relatively healthy, but actually they were full of sugar. If you're enjoying this video, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell below. So I managed to almost completely cut out sugar from my diet for about a month and a half. And I found after that time, when I, had like a fruit squash drink or something like that, I just found the taste was so sickly sweet, I couldn't even drink it. But after around 2 months, I went back to eating sugary things just because I have a sweet tooth, I love desserts, and eating is one of the joys of life, and I don't want to be deprived from, you know, something which I enjoy. I love eating. So it's more pragmatic and more sensible in the long term to kind of adjust your diet and find alternatives to the things you enjoy. So some of the suggestions I've got, so like I said, yogurt was one of the big things for me. So I found this soya yogurt, which is plain, has no sugars added to it. I found this a really good solution for the yogurt. For things like cakes and biscuits and sweets, I started eating cereal bars and like nuts protein bars, which I really love. But then I realized they are stuck together with honey and with syrup and really sugary stuff like that. So I started to look into making my own sugar-free desserts. So I bought Total Sweet, which is a sweetener which is made of xylitol, which comes from the bark of birch and beech trees. Now, this is called different things in different countries, but the main thing is xylitol. This is good for your teeth, which is amazing because it's, you know, sugar's so bad, and it's got 40% less calories than sugar. And the great thing is that you can use this when you're baking and cooking with recipes. It says that you can use it in the same amount of sugar, but I've found you need to use much more to get the same sweetness, the same kick as sugar. So I've found you need about double, but you need to experiment with it yourself to find out, you know, what works for you. So I've been cooking with this, and I made muffins, which I'll just show you a picture of now. They're not as sweet as, I suppose, ones which are using sugar, but they're really tasty, and they came out really well. This is only the second time I've ever cooked anything in my whole life, by the way. Honestly, I don't like cooking, but when you're thinking of replacing stuff you're buying in the supermarket with stuff which is much healthier for you and doesn't have all those additives, it kind of motivates me. This is what I made today. So I was talking about the protein bars. So this is basically Rice Krispies, sugar-free Rice Krispies, which are crushed up, and I put pumpkin seeds. I put let me just show you this. This is a almost sugar-free chocolate bar, which is called Choco Logic, and it has 3.2 grams of sugar per 100 grams. So this is sweetened with stevia, which is another sweetener. So I melted this, I put it over the seeds and the, I put some nuts, some hazelnuts, some crushed hazelnuts, a bit of dried coconut, and then you put it in the fridge for half an hour, and it comes out in these bars, just like the ones you buy. And again, they're not as sweet, but these are really, really delicious. I really like these. Oh. And again, for me to cook something, so I tell you, this is easy. So the thing to say about xylitol as well is it's poisonous to dogs and cats and other animals, so make sure you keep it away from your pets. I bought this for £10.50 in Holland & Barrett for 1 kilo. That may sound like a lot of money for a sweetener, but it's, if you look at the long run, how it's going to be much better for your health, I think it is definitely worth the money. You can buy it in Sainsbury's and Tesco's for £2.50, but it's a much smaller pack, so this works out as more economic. The other thing to say is that if you have too much of this, it can have a laxative effect. The thing with sweeteners is that after a while of using them, your body can no longer distinguish whether it's real sugar or a sweetener. So it treats it as if it's sugar anyway. So this is the only exception. It doesn't happen with xylitol. And the final thing to say is that there are two versions of xylitol. You can buy one which is made in China, and it's basically heat treated, and loads of chemicals are used to produce it, and it's not as good for you. The one which is produced in the EU is made from tree bark, and it's more natural. So it's a sustainable European birch and beech wood. Automatically after a meal, I would want a really sweet dessert. So I started to retrain myself. So that dessert could actually be, you know, the yogurt or it could be fruit. A good thing to understand is a glycemic index. So it basically lists everything. You can Google this online. So for example, if you look at fruits, some fruits are really high in sugar, such as mango, pineapple, red grapes, and watermelons. There are fruits which are much lower and much better to eat, such as apricots, apples, peaches, blueberries. You can check all this out online. So the last option that you have is using skincare which has anti-glycation properties. So there's a brand called SkinCeuticals which you can Google, and they have lots of creams that you can rub in which claim to be anti-glycation. Now, I haven't actually gone down this route because I don't think rubbing something topically onto your skin is going to affect what's happening inside. I think glycation is much more about what you're consuming rather than, you know, trying to fix it, you know, with an easy fix like that. So I don't personally think that's going to do much, but you could try that. You could try one of those products and see how it goes. So let me know if you've got any tips about cutting sugar from your diet, or if you've used xylitol, or if you've got any comments, please put them below. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please subscribe and hit the bell. Thanks very much for watching, and have a great day.